Hello everyone, today we are going to study a very important topic, that is half range expansion for Fourier series. Usually students make it a bit complicated or a bit confusing because there are again two cases for half range cosine and half range sine. As the name suggests, half range in the sense it is usually half of the range. How many ranges have we covered up till now? We have covered 0 to 2 pi. We have covered minus pi to pi, we have covered 0 to 2L, and we have covered minus L to L. 0 to 2 pi, half is 0 to pi, and minus pi to pi, that is negative to positive, again it will be 0 to pi. So whenever for half range, it can be usually be for 0 to pi or 0 to L. So whenever the sum is for 0 to pi or 0 to L, we have to generally find the Fourier expansion for half range expansion. Okay, the concept says that when we find the Fourier expansion for half range, there are again two types of Fourier expansion. Half range cosine series. First, we'll study what is half range cosine series. Usually, half range cosine series is we draw a vertical axis on a vertical axis, that is y axis. We draw a function between 0 to L and then we take the reflection of that 0 to L on the negative sides. So that becomes the range for minus L to L. Anyway, let us see an example for half range cosine series. Again, for half range cosine series, there are two cases. Case one is 0 to L and case 2 will be 0 to pi. So whatever L is, which has a constant number. So whenever the sum is for 0 to L, let us consider, go back, and we have seen the examples for even odd function. Whenever the function was even, what we did? Bn was 0, correct. So now in half range cosine series, we will not have bn anyway. We will just have a0 and an. So same as the formula, my 0 to L, because the range is 0 to L, f of x dx. And my an formula is same as the earlier as we saw, 0 to L, f of x cos of n pi x by L dx. Okay, so this is my two coefficient. So obviously my Fourier expansion will be f of x is a naught by 2 plus summation n goes from 1 to infinity a n cos of same as this angle n pi x by L. Okay, don't worry about the capital L or small L. These are just notation. If it is capital, obviously this will be capital. Anyway, you write capital or small L, that doesn't matter. Okay. Now, case 2. If the series is for range 0 to pi, if the series is for range 0 to pi, my coefficient, first coefficient a naught will be, because the series is for 0 to pi, it will be f of x dx. You can compare this and this. Only the difference is for the range. Here it is L and here it is pi. And an will be 0 to pi f of x cos of nx. Because n pi x upon pi. Pi pi will get cancelled. So we have this. Obviously my final Fourier expansion will be f of x is a naught by 2. Plus summation n goes from 1 to infinity an cos nx. So this will be my case 1 and case 2. So depending upon the sum, we look into the sum. If the range is 0 to constant number, then we'll apply this formula. If the range is for 0 to pi, then we'll apply this formula. So for easier way, you just remember, whenever it is half range cosine series, the formula resembles to the even function formula. Now let us see for the half range sine series. So now for half range sine series, again we'll consider two cases, 0 to L case and 0 to pi case. So depending on the example, we have to decide which formula to apply. Now half range sine series, the formula will resemble to what? The odd function formula. So what it is, you odd function formula, that is we extend the function 0 to minus L. The extended function is the odd function. So the formula will resemble to the odd function formula. In the odd function, we do not find a naught and an. We just find the coefficient for bn. So for 0 to L, we'll just find the coefficient for bn. The formula is same, 0 to L, and it is f of x. Obviously, with bn, you know it is, what is the formula? Sine. With a naught and an, you don't have sine. But whenever we have bn, it will be sine. So only you have to find bn. So obviously my Fourier series expansion will not be a0 by 2. It will just be bn, and it will be sine of n pi x by l. So this is my Fourier series expansion if it is in the range 0 to l. Now for the next case, similarly as we did for this, we just have to find bn. So the odd function, we take the extended form of the odd function, and then we take the image of it on the vertical axis. Okay, so bn will be what? 2 by pi, it will be 0 to pi and f of x. If I substitute pi pi, it will get cancelled, so you'll just have sine of nx dx. So now my final Fourier series for half range Fourier series, half range sine series for 0 to pi will be f of x is summation. N goes from 1 to infinity. It is just bn sine nx. So it will be more easier whenever you get a half range. You just have to find one of the coefficient. And the advantage over even and odd function is you don't have to check whether the function is even or odd. Directly, if you get the example, to find the half range sine expansion, you use either of one formula, whatever the question demands. And if you have the half range cosine series example, you use either of these two formulas. So total four formulas we have seen in this lecture. So depending upon the example, you have to choose your formula. So this was the overall summary of the half range expansion. I hope you have understood it.